square pants, square biz. Most niggas like small booties, nigga, trying to deny it. You ain't gotta have all that ass sometimes. Shaking, you think you might pass out just from a 20-step run and shit. Telling you, okay? I'm trying to work on that though. Sometimes. But I try for Lyft. Yeah, that sucks, right? He's definitely broke. Right? He's the only motherfucker that cut. So basically, I end up with like $500 a week after working like 60 hours. But I know my ultimate goal is to have the vehicle, so I kind of don't give a fuck because I get to come to places like this to see you guys. And that's my ultimate goal. Yes. Thank you. So I just drove 100 miles. Okay. Thank you. And I smoked the whole entire fucking time. I text messaged. I smoked. I looked on fucking Facebook. I plucked my chin hairs, my mustache. Like, itch my crotch a couple times. Like, if these motherfuckers really knew what we did inside of our cars, right? Like, this shit's crazy. Like, I mean, for me, I love picking my boogers. Anybody like picking the boogers? It's one of the best things for me. If you ever see a bitch with just like a fingernail right here, just like the front one, maybe the back one, that's a nose picker right there. I can let all the rest go, because this one gotta go straight up the booty hole. Like online and shit. You know what I'm saying? Anybody past 200 pounds, you know you shit out chicken nuggets. Like every day, you shit out a thumb-sized poop. And you're super excited about that shit, right? But you're like, I know there's more up in that motherfucker. Get that baby wipe up in there. Get all comfortable on that seat. Start relaxing that booty hole, opening it up and shit. Get the finger up in there. And I'm sure, like, my arms, even though it's not a big ass, it's kind of a big ass. So unfortunately, I gotta like, you know, get like an extra stretch. Sometimes I get one of the fat girl cramps, you gotta pause and shit, you're like, oh my God. Get up in there, get the fucking chocolate pearls, little duck nuggets, plump them out, right? Sit there and rock it back and forth. A few minutes later, you're like, my stomach. Rocky Foamy. It's my favorite time of the day. Best part of waking up is not Folgers in your motherfucking cup. It's seeing at least a banana poop in the toilet. I want to see at least a banana a day. I'm disappointed if not. I started the chia seed. Anybody like chia seed? That shit's a son of a bitch right there. Right? Because number one, if you keep it in the water for more than 5 minutes, it is definitely sperm. That's why they call it protein. That shit is sperm. Okay, so it gets to this consistency where it feels like you're drinking a cup of sperm. So as it's going down, I'm going every fucking day. And then the same thing out my ass. You never know, after like 3 days, all of a sudden, you just take a fart and you got chia seeds coming out your ass. Like, what the fuck? I know I'm not shitting, am I? What the fuck? Like, I'm getting kind of over this shit. Like, this shit's no joke. And if you don't have a baby wipe, man, that should tear your booty hole up real quick. Right? Just like how many folds do we have in that booty hole? And if you fuck one of them up and rip them up in one way, next thing you know, you got blood coming out your ass. Hemorrhoids and shit, that's disgusting. It's fucking sick. So, I'm dating. Anybody dating? Anybody single? This is my cousin, by the way. Thank you for driving hella far, dude. I love you so much. You're amazing. She's in her dating factor. I don't know if she's really on a date right now. This guy's just a friend. But you drove really far with her, and I really think you deserve at least a little head at the end of the night. She is my family, so I assume she is amazing. bunch of crazy bitches in my family, I'll tell you what. Right? I'm single because of one of my crazy bitch families, okay? I don't need to get into too many details, but what I will tell you is that I dealt with a man that cheated on me back and forth for many fucking years. Okay? Anybody else dealt with that?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? Fuck that, bitch. I'm all on internet dating, just like that nigga was, right? I'm out there, right? And the first motherfucker that I met, he was black, he said he was 5'10", and I was ready to give the pussy up, you know? I was ready to fuck. Next thing you know, I show up, this nigga's like 5'2". I'm like, what the fuck? You said he was 5'10", and he looked just like that nigga's best friend. Oh, right. I was like, prime opportunity. What'd you say, you want to get drunk? I'm going to get extra drunk because I'm going to suck the fuck out your dick right now. I'm on hate revenge right now. I don't give a fuck who you are right now. Right? We go back to his motherfucking house, and he said he was single, okay? You guys, okay, he said he was single. I'm going to start there. Before we get into the house, he asked me if I wanted to lock my motherfucking car in his gate. Hell no, I'm not going to lock my car in your little ass gate. What's going to happen here? Nigga, I need to escape. But them was like them crazy ass fucking gates that was like sharp up, and you're already thinking this is dangerous. I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm a dangerous, adventurous kind of person, so I was like, what's going to happen? And I'm ready to have that revenge sex and fuck my ex's best friend. I'm good, right? So I go up in there, and we start kissing and shit, and we kissing on an air mattress in the motherfucking living room, right? He got a two-bedroom. I'm like, why are we out here in an air mattress and shit? Are you sure you ain't got no girlfriend up this motherfucker? This is kind of weird. So we continue to drink and smoke. Next thing you know, we fuck, right? And I'm basically ready to exit, right? And I'm like, how the fuck do I exit this shit, right? So I'm like, let me go to the bathroom real quick. I go to the bathroom and I see two toothbrushes. I was like, oh, shit. Oh shit. He was like, hey babe, you can grab something out the fridge if you're thirsty. Cause we done fucked for hours at that point in time. Like I said, I had some revenge sex. I was swallowing that nigga's cock, swallowing his balls, slapping him on the air mattress just to make a little noise and shit. Get a little extra excitement. Ooh yeah. So I go to the kitchen to get something to drink and there's a motherfucking wheelchair. I'm like, both your rooms open. One of them got dogs in them, and the other one can have that bitch tied up. That's fucked up, but she's listening to us having sex right now because she's handicapped, you know what I'm saying? At any moment now, this bitch can come, yang, sliding out the fucking room like, I knew you were gonna do this to me, Anton. And I'm like, oh my God, let me get the fuck out of here. So I fucked him real good one more time. So I had to give the bitch what she wanted. She ain't coming out the room yet. So I fucked real good next time. Next thing you know, he's falling asleep. I'm like, let me get the fuck out of here. I start running out the door, and I realize he got this weird ass lock on there and shit. So I had to hop out the window. I hop out the window all slow and shit. Slip on the motherfucking airbed, coochie all up on the shit. I'm not having fun right now, right? I'm tripping. I'm like, get me the fuck out of here. Then I got this gate situation. I'm like, oh my God. And I'm thinking, is he watching me this whole time? Is something happening? I get this gate, I get the motherfucking a chair. I start hopping over the chair. Thank God I parked right there because I used it as leverage. But as I used it as leverage and I was leaning towards it, I was wearing one of these sweaters like this and it got caught on this motherfucking fence. So now I'm dangling from this fucking fence. And I'm like, oh my God, lean it, get the fuck out of here, abort! Get the fuck out of there. And lately I drove to LA for some dick. I'm that horny. I will drive to LA for some dick. Right? Y'all don't even know how horny bitches is, right? For me, it's terrible that you motherfuckers want to drive by hella fast because there's so many horny bitches that are just sitting there going, oh, you look sexy today. You look good. Like if you guys could see me in the chair, I'd be like this all the whole way. I'm ready to fuck the shit out of you. You fine as fuck. God, I'm flexing my pussy on you right now. Like, we are horny while we're driving. By the time we get there, we are soft the fuck up. And we ain't even going nowhere but mama's house. We get there like, ugh. letting go, so you gotta take all the time with her, you know what I'm saying? So either way, the main thing I've been thinking about is how am I gonna masturbate? It's real, right? Sometimes you get the phone porn and you're trying to masturbate and shit, and then you hear your mama's cough in the background, and you're like, God damn it, mama. Get the fuck out the house for 30 minutes. This shit's terrible. Then you try to get up in the shower and you try to pull that thing down. You just be like, buzz, 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 buzz. Start fucking your clit with it. Next thing you know, you hear your mom's voice, God damn it, mom. It's almost fucking there, you know what I'm saying? Almost there every fucking time. So finally, when that bitch leaves, first thing I do is hop in the shower. I ain't even playing. And I'm gonna prop myself up, cause I'm gonna lose all kind of control on this motherfucker, right? Hell yeah, I'm like bang to bang. Like this is the side to side. I ain't going no more. No more. I'm propping it up. I'm getting ready. I'm fucking. My head is eventually gonna go like this. And I'm gonna start losing control of shit, right? Last thing, I had like a brain aneurysm. I don't know what happened. I got like 6 fucking good nuts in a row, just pissing all over the place, fucking my shit up. Next thing you know, I feel like this shit's getting tired. My pussy getting real tired. It's worn the fuck out. Next thing you know, I try to move my neck and it's like, oh shit. Felt like I was about to die. Everything was like, ring, ring, ring. I was like, that was how you fuck yourself right there. Shit. Pussy is fresh and clean. I'm telling you what. Ain't never been fresher right there. I love to save money too. Don't use the toilet paper right after you take a shit. Just hop right out of the motherfucking shower. Start rinsing that ass. Watch them bean casing go down. Where did I eat corn? There's hella corn kernels. I need no goddamn popcorn. Who the fuck you been up there? It's kind of gross. But it's cool at the same time. It's pretty disgusting. You know? Especially like the period blood too. Oh, fuck yeah. You bitches do that. Act like you fucking don't. Day 2, that shit is bloody as a motherfucker. You is not having it. You sit on that toilet for about 20 minutes, just letting that motherfucker go, step on in the shower, ba-boom. Just cherry jam everywhere, just stop, 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 stop. Look at that go, yes. And your head gets like, feels good. And then you continue. Continue. You guys like period sex?
Yeah!
Yeah! All those who are lying, right? It's okay, you just stick a cork in it, you guys can still eat the pussy, right? Hell yeah, we got DK back there. Well, you have a San Francisco 49ers jacket on, so you won't do anything, right? I feel like you have been to jail and been in certain circumstances, if you know what I'm saying. So, hey, that's what I'm talking about. Circumstantial gaze, right? I mean, they're everywhere. Guys are gay. You guys don't think so? Like, I'm hella lesbian. Like, I'm not lesbian, but y'all bitches look good as fuck. I'll be like, God damn, you look pretty tonight. You must have took 45, 60 minutes to get ready. You look real good tonight. Them titties look juicy. I don't know what it is. It's just my eyes just go straight to it. You know what I'm saying? Just like when TK was up here, he got that little dick dangle. The only reason why the girls were not responding because they're going, you ain't gonna take it out. You ain't gonna take that shit out, you fucking lying ass motherfucker. Because we all know what happens when you take out your limp dick. It's about this big. We don't want none of that limp little turtle. Okay? Nobody likes limp little turtle. They be like, babe, suck that shit. Make that shit hard. No, nigga, you make that shit hard. That is disgusting. And then you'd be like, are you ready yet, little guy? Like, babe, this ain't exciting you. I don't know what the fuck to do, right? Because I ain't finna play with this limp-ass dick for like 30 minutes. Either you ready for this motherfucking shit or you ain't. Because I'm finna give you deep throat if you can get it hard because I don't like soft cock, right? And then when you start fucking and a nigga starts going all limp and shit, it feels so disgusting, I want you guys to know. Makes us ladies cringe, just like, oh. And you can feel it getting smaller and pointy. disgusting. Telling you. But anyways, my name is Aisha Birdsong, okay? You guys can find me on Facebook. I do a podcast out in the city. It's called Glow Wednesday on Mutiny Radio FM. And then, yeah. And you guys can find me at Broke. I'm really, like, trying to establish, like, lengthy in your brain so you guys can remember it. It's BrokeBitch101 on Instagram. Like, that shit's legit. Like, I'm super broke. Like, the last time I got weed from somebody, they said, would you like to suck my dick in place of payment? I said, yes, sir. Thank you very much. I really need this money. So I felt like, you know, like a hooker, but nah. It's like, fuck, I'm not a hooker. I'm good. But anyways, I'm BrokeBitch101_FutureBillionaire on Instagram. You guys find me, check out other shows, check out my podcast.